Hi, welcome back to my channel where I show you how I designed some of my favorite cars. And today I'm going to be showing you the process I took for the Ferrari F430. Not an easy mission, because the brief on the 430 was to actually do something based on the 360, its previous version. In other words, take a car that was already considered one of the more beautiful Ferraris and make it even nicer. Big boots to fill with that one. You won't see the 360 appear on the page, but you'll see something similar to it evolving as I go through the motions here. And you'll start to see a 360 that could have evolutionized a bit further into something a little bit more dynamic. I always felt that the 360 was a bit soft, as if they'd left it in the oven a bit too long, and it got a little bit, not blobby, but definitely not as hard-edged as it could have been. It's not a McLaren where everything is minimalized. You add a little bit on Ferraris to get that sensuality. Now, what we have to do is still feed the same radiators. It's a little bit more dynamic, a little bit larger, more impressive to look at, I would say. Getting some of the shapes. Intakes were always pretty much in the same areas on the 360, but the 430 had to become a bit more bite. It loses the friendliness of the previous version. I think this is the only car in the world to ever have the name of the car imprinted on the actual mirror body itself. And if you look at an F430, you'll notice that it has F430 debossed as a graphic into that side of the housing of the mirror body. Very short distance on a Ferrari, on this one especially, between the shut line for the door and the wheel cutout. But we broke it up a little bit here in the front with a vent that did take some of the air out. And all these vents are effective, believe me. So many cars these days that I get upset about when I see that there's a vent and it actually has no purpose or blocked off and just tries to look like a sports car, tries to give the impression that it's a vent and it's not. I don't understand that type of design. As this comes along, you'll start to see it take shape. And again, one of the elements that did help distinguish it strongly from the earlier version, the 360, was the taillights. Now, we know that Ferrari generally has round taillights in the back. Most oftentimes, you'll see them doubled up. So you have four round taillights, two on the left, two on the right. The idea of actually taking the taillights from the 360 and moving them upwards really helped. I think it was a very, very good move. So took the taillights and moved them up and out of the surface of the rear. So you had two lights on either side, but they were up and out of the surface. Very dynamic. It kind of made it look like it was bulging out of the surface. Purposely, I haven't at the moment put in exhaust pipes here. I haven't put in the grill because the grill was very special. We have things when we design cars that as designers, we try to amplify or accentuate them. That's one thing. It's called tumble home. Tumble home is when you have the body of the car, say, from a front on or rear view, you have the section of the doors, which tend to be bulbous or rounded, and where they meet the glass at the waistline here, the more we lean the glass in, it means the more tumble home that we have. And that tends to look very dynamic. In the old days, cars didn't have much tumble home. They were pretty much upright and gave you plenty of space on the inside of the car. But as cars got wider and wider, we were able to increase the tumble home in the interior of the on the exterior of the car and not sacrifice too much of the space. I'm gonna just put in a bit of this in here. So I'm bringing the shoulder line out, and you can see that there is becoming bit more strong than if I hadn't have done it. Kind of hard when you're drawing to make sure that your drawing is symmetrical. The more you draw, the more feeling you get for what's right and what's not right, what works and what proportions are correct and not. So, and now as we get to the front, you'll start to see something emerge that is very distinctive on this car. We have a bonnet shut line. Typically they always come inwards as you come forward, and then they'll meet and joined together. From this view, you'll see a little bit of the front wheel. We try to hide most of the front wheel simply for aerodynamics. And you can't do it completely, or otherwise the design will turn into a square box from the front, and that definitely does not look good. The process of finding a look for the front end of this Ferrari was not an easy one, in the sense that we tried pretty much everything we could come up with. We still just weren't nailing it. We were coming close, but it wasn't Ferrari. By researching what were the successful Ferraris of the past, one of those cars was the 1961 Shark Nose. That was a Formula One car developed by Ferrari, famously driven by Phil Hill. And that car had a front end that was as distinctive as they come. And so what I did was capitalize on those two elements, the shark nose or the nostrils of the front of the car, and reinterpreted them in, say, a much more modern way, I guess. And that instantly nailed the design. It was one of those things, when you saw it, you knew it was right. I don't think of any solution could have been better than the one that we came up with. And as I draw it in here, you'll see how it resembles some of the other shapes that are already on the car. You can see here, these two openings, as dramatic as they seem on paper in 2D, nailed it in 3D. Again, the lesson here for me was always look back into the history of the company you're working with and try to find something that is strong and powerful, but you can modernize it, because to copy old solutions, that's a sin in my book. But to use the inspiration from the older designs is a great idea, to continue the genetical link to the past. They were always radicalizing the design of a Ferrari and not being too successful doing it, or taking elements of Ferraris and accentuating them, making them a bit more emphatic in a certain way, and pushing that design language of the Ferrari forward. So again, if you look at this here, I think you recognize Ferrari in many of the elements, but at the same time, it's pushing the game forward for Ferrari. But back in the day when Ferraris were non-turboed, these cars non-turboed, there was a element of romance and finesse to the design, that, not to say that they aren't beautiful today, but they are losing that character that we had a few decades or a couple decades ago, where cars were less monster looking, less aggressive. There was an amount of artistic finesse to the car that made it stand out. So there you have it, a little bit of design process of how I came up with the evolution of the 360 to turn it into something, as the brief was asking for, a bit more beautiful, a bit more aggressive, a bit more Ferrari-esque for the new era, and another favorite project of mine. So thanks.